Any object flying through space has inertia. Its velocity will only change if an external force acts on it, and its angular velocity will only change if an external force generates a torque on it. In the absence of any external force, the object will continue traveling forward at the same speed and continue spinning around its center of mass at the same speed. Forever. Although all of this is true, part of it can be misleading. To the chalkboard! Alright, let me explain. As we watch a completely unsuspicious-looking chopstick flying through space, we can observe that it has linear momentum. Its linear momentum is just its mass times its velocity. If we were to flick that chopstick at its center of mass, because completely unsuspicious-looking chopsticks are infinitely thin, its linear momentum would change. We could calculate how its momentum should change according to the size, direction, and duration of the force. In the presence of any non-zero net external force, the linear momentum will change. The chopstick's new momentum would be its old momentum added to the force times duration. In other words, the change in momentum, or impulse. So, the chopstick would continue moving like this. Similarly, we could look at another completely unsuspicious-looking chopstick spinning in place. It has angular momentum, which is just its moment of inertia times its angular velocity. If we were to flick that chopstick at a certain distance from its center of mass, we would change its angular velocity. We could calculate how its angular momentum should change according to the size, direction, duration, and location of the force. The angular momentum will change in the presence of any non-zero net external torque, which is simply a product of the force and the distance away from the center of mass at which the force was applied. The chopstick's new angular momentum would be its old angular momentum added to the torque times time. In other words, the change in angular momentum. So, you might expect the chopstick to continue moving like this, right? Well, sorry, that's wrong. Or rather, it's only half right. This is what really should happen. The calculations that we did to find the new angular momentum are all correct, but we forgot about something else. We said earlier that linear momentum should change in the presence of an external force. Here's an external force. Sure, it changed the angular momentum, but according to the laws of physics, that same force should also change the linear momentum. Every external force on an object will try to change both linear and angular momentum. But hang on, if we go back to our first completely unsuspicious-looking chopstick, we found that the external force only changed its linear momentum. I thought we just found out that all forces try to change both types of momentum. So why didn't that force change its angular momentum? Well, it sort of did. It's just that it was zero. The change in angular momentum can be found with time and torque. As before, torque is just force crossed with distance. But we explicitly flicked the chopstick at its center of mass, so the radius is zero. This, in turn, means that the torque is zero, and the angular momentum does not change. But nevertheless, although both types of momentum are presented separately, they are both always present, and every external force influences both of them. Otherwise, they'll just keep on keeping on.